In previous lessons, we talked about Sulasi, Mujarrad, Afa'al and their three patterns. Now we will extend it further. So far, we have discussed past tense verbs. All Arabic verbs originally begins with past tense, which is called fi'li madhi. Arabic grammarians have made a group of six verbs that form the basis of changing other's verb into present and future tense. These are as follows. Like zaraba changes into yazribu, nasara changes into yansuru, samia changes into yasma'u, fataha changes into yaftahu, hasiba changes into yahsibu, and karuma changes into yakurumu. Arabic dictionaries therefore include the first letter of one of these groups with each new verb to inform the readers how it can be changed into present or future. For example, when we search the verb zahaba into dictionary, we find a small letter fa alongside which indicate that the verb zahaba will be changed on the pattern of fataha yaftahu. Like when we see zahaba, zahaba into dictionary, alongside this verb we'll find a small letter fa to indicate that this verb will be changed like fataha yaftahu. Fataha yaftahu is this. And as fataha yaftahu has been changed as yaftahu, similarly zahaba will also be changed like this. Yes ha bu. So this is the pattern. And this pattern is very important to know that how verbs are changed. For each verb, we should know from which bab it has come, so that we could change it into present or future tense. And this tense is called fi'l muzari. Zahaba yazhabu, yazhabu is fi'l muzari. These are fi'l mazi and these are fi'l muzari. And the other important point about this is that fi'l muzari is for both, for present as well as future. It will be known when a sentence is written that whether it is for present or future, the context will tell you that whether it is for present or for future. So yazhabu is for both. Yazhabu means he goes or he will go. Zahaba means he went. But yazhabu is meant for both. So this point should be remembered. And now I will take up, as I told you, this is for the time being, and I will continue this lesson for more details in other lessons. And now I'll take up the numeral. So I'll rub it out and I will now take up numerals from 71 onwards. So 71 is written like this. It is ahada wa sab'un. It is to be ahada wa sab'un. Wa sab'un. Ahada wa sab'un. Then 72 is written like this. It means isna wa sab'un. Isna wa sab'un. Then 73 should be written like this. It is Salasa wa sab'un. Salasa wa sab'un. Wa sab'un. Then 74 is written like this. It is Arba wa sab'un. Arba wa sab'un. Then 75 is written like this. Khamsa wa sab'un. Khamsa wa sab'un. Then 76 is written like this. Sitta wa sab'un. It is Sitta wa sab'un. Then 77 is to be written like this. Then Saba wa sab'un. Saba wa sab'un. Then 78 is to be written like this. Tamaniya wa sab'un. Tamaniya wa sab'un. Then 79 is to be written like this. Tis'a wa sab'un. Then samaniyun means 80. 80 is to be written like this. 80. It is samaniyun. Samaniyun. So this is for today, and we'll continue the Sulasi Mujarrad Afa'al in our next lesson. So if you like the video, you please subscribe it and push the bell icon so that subsequent videos could reach you. Thank you very much.